esempi proprio di finti marmi, finti legni,
molto interessante.
Architettura.
Irene Marconi, ci fanno segno che ormai è finita. Grazie.
Grazie a lei.
Ecco tutto.
Sir.
You looking for a new job?
Yeah, always. There's a chance I'll be moving back to New York.
Trying out that whole acting thing again, eh?
Well, you know how it is. There's nothing for me here now, so I'll see how badly New York treats me, you know? Don't you think you came back a little too soon?
Well, I've got to pay the rent and money talks, so...
Well, if you needed money, I can always help
you. I don't borrow.
Commitments è il titolo del film di cui avete appena visto un clip di questo lungometraggio dal cineasta, regista locale, italo-canadese Joe Rossi. Hi, Joe.
Hi.
Nice to have you back. Third time here. We've completed a feature-length film entitled Commitments. It's a personal inspiration, so I'd like for you to talk about how you came about writing a script dealing with commitments.
Well, the script came from all the stories and rumors I used to hear as a child and as an adolescent, and a family as large as mine. There would always be stories about breakups, marriages, divorces, and I thought that would be an interesting film.
Well, you're talking about a specific topic that, especially in this day and age right now, is very complex. I mean, to write a script about that and having the stories gel and manage that kind of situation is quite challenging, no?
I don't see the film as a linear piece. I mean, the film is kind of all over the place in terms of the actual theme of committing, but I find that refreshing because I don't view life like that. I view life as a more of a, you know, a mishmash of events, and that's what the film is like.
And how were the people who helped you out also, and that you were able to represent a part of your life, you know, everyday life, on screen, which is seldom seen right now in films today, and even in Montreal films, how did they react to all of this, and how were you able to manage them?
Well, the cast, we work with a local casting house and theater school, the Montreal School of Performing Arts, and they supplied a group of great actors, and the crew, I've worked with them many times before, so it was really, really a camaraderie.
Set us up for the next clip that we're about to see.
The next clip is with two good actors, Jill de Monreal, who plays Nora, and Ken Proulx, who plays Steve. And basically, it's a meeting of sorts at a local restaurant. Basically, just meet and decide that they actually like each other.
Interesting. Adesso andiamo a vedere un altro clip di questo film, Commitments.
Hi. How you been?
Good. Sit. I didn't get a chance to talk to you much last time I saw you. How about you? How have you been?
I can't complain. I mean, work's a bitch and all that, but what's with all the papers?
Oh. Just forms for the salon.
Right. Yeah, how's that going?
Honestly, my partner has her head in the clouds.
It's been a rough past couple weeks. I mean, I'm sure it'll get better with time.
I guess. But she's always been like this. She shies away from responsibility ever since I've known her.
Mm. È proprio interessante questo secondo clip del film, rappresenta anche dei momenti di cui tutti noi italiani possiamo anche avere un'affinità. It's a great affinity that we have in this clip. We can actually see, we can actually be a part of that, you know, it's so real. I was wondering if you could talk a bit about that scene again when you were shooting it, and how were you able to use your crew to your advantage?
Well, we shot at a restaurant owned by a friend of mine who I work with, Manny Costa, Carl Zambino's. And he allowed us to shoot there. We were a crew that day, about five in the cast of two, and we just showed up and did the work. We worked very well together, the crew. We're all friends from high school, elementary school, film school, so we're all on the ball. And the cast, well, I couldn't get a better cast. I've worked with Gilda before, and she's always stellar, and Ken Proulx is proved to be one of the best actors I've ever worked with, so it was kind of an easy day.
You're very positive about this whole adventure about shooting a film in a scene. You just make a film. We have a cast, we have a crew, we have a set, and here we are, we have it. But it's actually very complex to make a film, to actually have the finished product 2-3 years down the road. So we have very little time. I'd like for you to tell me a day in the life of shooting that film.
We wake up in the morning, eat breakfast, pick up the camera and shoot. I mean, it's as easy as that, because I don't see it as any more than an enjoyable ordeal. I mean, I love it. To me, the true juice of it is actually shooting the film. Whatever comes after and before, it's well and done, but the actual shooting of the film, I actually think it is the greatest part of the process.
Do you let it, we have about 20 seconds left, do you let your actors just be free and also be able to improvise with your script?
Well, I cast the actors, I think I cast them well on this one. I mean, if they needed the coaching or the direction, I would have given it to them, but they just knew what to do and just rolled with it.
Well, we are very eager to see this film. It's at the Leonardo da Vinci Center. Which date again?
It's on August 4th.
Perfect. We will be there il 4 agosto prossimo. Andate a vedere questo film al Centro Leonardo da Vinci. Buon cinema.
I like to help promote the Italian community by showing the viewers of global television how Italians celebrate their certain festivities and events. And I think it helps promote who we are as a culture. Watch Summer in the City on Montreal's Evening News at 6 with Jamie Orchard.
Ciao, sono Sonia Benedetto. Vi invito a guardare Siamo, mercoledì alle 19.
Athletic performance, lightweight, sporty design, sport-tuned suspension, and an advanced CVT transmission to keep you running smoothly. Introducing the all-new 270-horsepower V6 Nissan Altima Coupe. True performance, true technology, true coupe.
Tomatoes, you touch. Bread, you squeeze. Watermelons, you tap. Herbs, you smell. Chicken, you read. Maple Leaf Prime Chicken's new Fresh Sure packaging, a revolutionary new pack design that seals in the freshness for a better, fresher tasting chicken. There's a reason we call it Prime.
Anyone seen Carrie? Right here, boss.
Okay. Caravan needs a wash.
Got it, chief.
The employee price discount is back. Purchase or lease a select new Chrysler Jeep or Dodge vehicle and get an employee price discount. Plus a gas card that will save you 20 cents a liter on the price of gas for 1 year. Only during the employee price discount event.
Siamo di ritorno ad Arte Mondo e oggi si parla di scultura. Non abbiamo spesso l'occasione di parlarne, quindi quando abbiamo proprio questa occasione ne approfittiamo. E quindi vi presento oggi il signor Jacek Jarnuszkiewicz. Merci, monsieur Jarnuszkiewicz. C'est un long nom, mais finalement, on va y arriver. On va y arriver.
Ça m'a pris du temps, moi aussi, à l'apprendre, certainement. Surtout à l'écrire.
Revenons à votre œuvre et votre parcours. Peut-être brièvement décrire pour nos téléspectateurs comment vous vous êtes lancé en sculpture, parce que en général on rencontre beaucoup d'artistes, peintres, des sculpteurs. Je pense qu'il y en a un petit peu moins. Pour vous, c'était quoi?
Oui, moi je viens d'une famille de sculpteurs. Je viens de Varsovie où tous mes oncles, mon père était sculpteur. Alors c'est quelque chose qui date depuis longtemps, exactement.
De père en fils.
Et puis je suis arrivé au Québec et j'ai étudié en histoire de l'art. Puis après ça, j'ai fait une maîtrise en dessin. Et puis après ça, j'ai enseigné à l'Université de Montréal en espace, c'est-à-dire des cours de sculpture. J'ai fait espace 1, espace 2, espace 3.
Parce que la sculpture, si on veut, on dit que l'architecture is a sculpture that we can walk through. Hein? On dit de ça de l'architecture. Hein? C'est une sculpture dans laquelle on peut rentrer, tandis que la sculpture, on fait le tour et on peut parfois peut-être même rentrer. Comment est-ce que vous voyez votre expression?
Oui, c'est sûr, d'autant plus si on fait, par exemple, d'art public, où on est souvent appelé à travailler en syncrétisme avec les architectes. Donc, c'est sûr que souvent c'est des pièces qui sont souvent à l'échelle beaucoup plus grande que l'humain. On rentre, on pénètre dans un labyrinthe, on peut... En fait, ça s'articule d'une façon souvent très complexe et très... à l'échelle très grande.
Exactement. Et d'ailleurs, on a un très bel exemple parce que récemment, il y a eu l'inauguration de la station à Laval, la station de métro, et vous avez participé, si on veut, hein, avec votre œuvre, L'homme est un roseau pensant. Peut-être nous décrire brièvement d'où est venue l'inspiration pour cette œuvre, parce que c'est quand même une œuvre monumentale, elle est grande. Là.
Oui, c'est une pièce, elle fait au-dessus de 14 mètres. Et puis, vous savez, en art public, souvent, ou bien on travaille tout de suite à élaborer un projet avec les architectes du point zéro, ou bien souvent, c'est pas possible, et puis on est obligé de, comme, si on peut dire, se greffer.